Hey everybody, my name's Andrew and I run this channel called Collective Intelligence. You've likely just gotten your hands on Ableton Lite. You may have opened it up, sat in front of it, and felt a little bit overwhelmed about how you get started making music and producing your own beats. So here I am to talk you through the process and show you step by step how to use this software. So what we're going to start with is by taking a quick look around the interface, getting ourselves familiar with what's happening inside of here, and we're going to do it in a fairly condensed period of time. I will be releasing other more in-depth videos following this one. They're all going to be in a playlist, and you'll find that playlist in the video description. In the comment section, I'll pin a post, and it'll have that video there. Playlist there. So let's jump into Ableton. Here we are. And what you can see right now is what they call the session view. Okay, so Ableton has two different ways that you can look at it. You can look at it as though you're sort of looking from the top down and you're looking at a whole bunch of loops and things that you can play over and over again, but you're not really looking at how the track is arranged. So if you press tab on your keyboard, that takes you across to what they call the arrangement view. And this is where you would be if you were arranging a track. And you can see it works something like a timeline from start to finish. Okay. Now, what we see here is we got some arrows. We got an arrow down here in the bottom right-hand corner. You should be able to see that underneath my collective intelligence thing here. And we've got an arrow up the top here. Now, what these do is if you click them, they drop away what we're looking at here as the browser window. So that drops away the browser window so that we can just see, you know, the complete arrangement view without any obstruction. Same's going on down here. If we click that, we drop away our instrument view or our audio effect view. We get rid of it, right? So we can look at a pretty clean piece of software in front of us like this, but we're going to keep them on. So that's how you drop them away. Another really helpful thing right off the bat is this little arrow down here. This shows or hides the help tab. And you can hover your little mouse over top of any one of these features and it's going to tell you exactly what it's going to do. Now, I'm not going to tell you what every single one of these buttons and thingy icons does. It would take too long. We don't want to be bored out of our mind. Let's talk about the ones that really matter to you right now. So, this is how you change your BPM, your beats per minute, all right? So, if you're playing some 4/4 music like techno or house or something like this, that's the kick drum that falls on every beat. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4, right? So, the speed is dictated by the BPM. So, how many times are you getting a kick in a minute period of time? So I'm going to go ahead and set the BPM to 140 because I like dubstep. 140 is dubstep speed. So that's all you really need to know about here. If you're playing instruments in, this is the metronome. So if you turn the metronome on and then you click on the timeline just with your left mouse button and then you press the space bar, what you're doing is you're pressing play. So it's going to start playing through your arrangement and you'll hear the metronome. So let's have a listen to the metronome. Right, sounds really interesting. So that's how you can play along in time and get things synced up nicely. So metronome, what else is interesting here? We've got play, if you want to press play manually. We've got stop. We got record, okay? So record, if we're going to record an instrument in, keep an eye on that Ableton Lite playlist. I'll be doing a how to record an instrument into Ableton. You'll be able to learn all about that in another video. I'm going to go ahead and show you how to loop something inside of the arrangement view. And I'm going to be focused today mostly on this arrangement view. In the future, I'm going to be getting a Novation Launchpad. I'm going to be showing you how to make a beat, and we'll be doing that in this view, the session view. And just remember, tab will toggle between the two views. You can also get between the two views with these two buttons right here, right? So as I press tab, you'll notice that it drops down to this one, drops back again. You can manually click them, right? So If I select an area that I would like to loop, I can hold the left mouse button and I can drag, right? Anywhere on this timeline in here, in this window here, I can click and drag. And then I could go something like Control L, right? And now you'll see that these brackets have fallen down. That's the loop brace. We're going to be looping around and around and around and around and around. We can make it small. So select that amount of area and go Control Loop. And if I want to zoom in, I'll show you how to zoom in a second, then I can make it even smaller, right? Because what I'm looking at here is I'm looking at one bar of music, two bars of music, three bars of music, four bars of music, et cetera, et cetera. And you can see the numbers up across the top dictate how many bars we're working with. So on the screen right now, we can see 77 bars. Now, the loop brace, you'll see that all of this area right here is in relation to the loop brace. So the loop brace right now is starting on the 17th bar, right? You can see that. And it's going for one bar. If I grab that and I pull that up, the loop brace increases. When this is solid yellow, it means that the loop brace is active. So as long as we're playing inside of here, when we get to the end, it goes back to the start. Right, so obviously if I start it here and I press play, it's just going to keep going. It's not going to loop back around. It's just going to go forever. But if I start it playing here, by the time it gets to that bar, it'll boom, go back to the beginning again. Cool. So all of this is in control in relation to the loop brace. So they're really the features that we need to know up here for now. You know, there's some more interesting ones here. Like you can see how hard your computer's struggling here with the CPU meter. Here you can click and you can MIDI map things. We'll talk about MIDI mapping in another video. You can key map. So we'll do that in other videos. And here, this one's quite interesting. Here you can actually use your computer keyboard. So one of these keyboards as one of these keyboards, right? So I can use the buttons on my computer keyboard to play musical notes. And that could be handy for you guys out there that just have a laptop or some sort of computer and you don't actually have a MIDI instrument or something to, you know, play on. You can do it with your keys. It's a little bit clunky, but when that is solid yellow, that is enabled. When that's turned off, the keyboard's just going to do regular keyboard functions, hotkeys, that sort of thing. So, what else can we talk about? What we're looking at here with the old pink, purple, baby blue, and it's lavender. Is it? Is it lavender or is that lavender? Jeez, guys. This is not a tutorial on how to tell different colors apart. You can change the color by right-clicking on it and changing it to whatever you like. Let's change it to some colors that we really can tell. I'm going to go ahead. That, oh, yeah, orange is nice. Oh, yeah, how about blue? Cool. So what we're looking at here is we're looking at channels, right? We're looking at channels. And we're seeing MIDI channels. And we're looking at audio channels, right? So we could grab an audio sample that we have. And we could chuck it on this channel. And then we could press play and we could listen to it, right? We could pop a MIDI instrument on this channel. And then we could make some MIDI and we could play that instrument using the MIDI, right? So these are the two different tracks that Ableton uses. And over time, you will become very familiar with the differences between an audio channel and a MIDI channel. In future videos, we'll be covering that sort of stuff. So don't worry. But essentially what's happening is MIDI is something that you got an instrument in there and you can play notes or you can draw notes into little clips, right? So what I'll do right now is I'll show you quickly how to make a MIDI clip and we'll put an instrument on it and I'll just show you very quickly how that's actually controlled. So I'm going to talk you through all of the steps in order to create the MIDI clip. I'm going to tell you the hotkeys. The hotkeys are going to be specific to Windows. If you're using a Mac, substitute either the Control or the Alt for the Command or whatever the other button on the Mac is. Generally speaking, the letter that I tell you is typically always the same letter. So if I go and select this area from the 33rd bar to the 34th bar and make it blue on the first MIDI channel, just with the left mouse button, click, drag, I can go Control, hold, so I press Control and I hold it. I press Shift and I hold it, and I press M, right? So Control Shift M, and now we've got this red MIDI clip. That is a MIDI clip. So on the MIDI channel, we create a MIDI clip. And now you can see down here that this has changed to something that looks like a piano roll, right? So if I click over here, piano roll disappears. Where's it gone? It's over here. I click it again, it's back. I draw notes inside of the MIDI clip, and then I get an instrument that I like the sound of, and I put it on this MIDI channel. When I press play at the start of the MIDI clip, it reads the MIDI notes, it makes a sound. Cool. Let's do it. So I'm going to draw some notes. Let's go C. And I didn't explain how I did that at all, so I'll delete it and we'll start again. So what we're looking at is a piano roll. I can see C3 here. Whatever you can see, like, it doesn't matter. It doesn't have to be any note. Just double click on the area between here and here, right? So when you press the notes, doesn't do anything. But you need to be between the one and the, should be a two there, but you can't see it. So this is one bar of musical time that we're looking at because we made the clip one bar long. So this clip here is this area here. And if I wanted to make the clip even longer, I could go to 33 to 37 and go control shift M again, right? It won't let me do it because I've already got one. If I want to make a longer one, I can go control J. That's consolidate, right? And I'll click two buttons at the same time. Let's do that again so it doesn't get confusing. I did Control Shift M for that MIDI clip, and then I decided I wanted to make it longer, so I can go Control J, and that consolidates it, kind of joins everything together. And the way that it works with MIDI is it just creates a longer clip. I could then decide to go, okay, I want a longer clip again, right? So I've made it really long. Okay, how do I go back? Control Z is reverse, and I'm throwing a lot of this stuff at you. Sorry, it could be a little bit overwhelming. You can rewatch the video, you can slow it down, you can write down the hotkeys. Control Z is for undo, and Control J is for consolidating, or think of it as joining things together. And then Control Shift M is for creating that MIDI clip when you're on a MIDI channel. That hotkey, when you're on an audio channel, it's not going to do anything, right? Didn't do anything just then. So let's draw the notes. I can double click on this area and it draws a little red note right like this, right? And if I put my cursor at the end of it, it turns into something like a bracket. And if I put it at the start, something like a bracket too. So that would be if I want to pull it this way. But that's pulling it before the start of the clip. The clip starts at the one. So anything negative value is, that's not actually what that's not in the clip, right? So I'm just going to get rid of that. Click here, drag. And I can just make one big long MIDI note, right? So you can see now there's a big black line in the middle of the screen. What does that indicate? It indicates that note. Cool. If I went and double clicked here and drew another one, okay, there's another one up there. Cool. I don't want that. How do I get rid of it? I can either click directly on it and press delete on the keyboard, or if I draw it again, I could double click it. Two ways to get rid of it. Sweet. So now we've got this note, but if we go to the start of it and we press play, all I'm hearing is the metronome. I'm going to turn the metronome off. Oh, so that guy just jumped onto the screen. Thank you very much for subscribing. Consider subscribing if you're watching the video and you like the way it's going. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to use the browser window now. So that's not making any sound. That's really boring. That's a shame. We want sound. We want to hear something. So I can come to the instruments and I can find some sort of instrument that's going to play something. Can operator is a typical Ableton instrument. So I'm going to open that up, open that tab, right? So instruments, open the tab. Excuse me. And then we can open any of these. Just go ahead and open any of them. Let's go the guitar, right? Okay, yeah, that one's good. Let's click that. So I grabbed that instrument and I was auditioning it, by the way. That's what happens. You can just click on them and you can hear them. So click it, drag, drop on the channel. Now it's on that channel. If I click on here, you can see the instrument is dropped in here. That's what it looks like. That's the operator and the patch that it's opened up to is this fifths one detuned, right? So, all right, cool. Now, if we go to the start of this MIDI clip by left clicking and I press spacebar, it's playing. And then when it gets to the end, it stops, right? So we've just made it do something with MIDI. So then we could come in here, and if I double click it, then I come back to the piano roll. How do I get there in an alternative way? Down the bottom here, we've got two tabs. This tab shows the instrument. This tab shows the clip. If I don't have the clip selected, then nothing shows up when I'm on this tab. So I click the clip, it shows up. Click this tab, shows me the instrument. I can make adjustments here. Then I decide, oh, I want to change notes. Come back over here. What are we going to do? We're going to go 1, 2, 3, 4 semitones up. And then we're going to go 1, 2, 3 semitones up from that one. And we're just going to, do some steps, right? And then we're going to go 1, 2, 3 semitones up from that. Or actually, we could go even higher. I'm going to show you another command. This one's pretty cool. We could put this one down here, right, on top of that other one. And if I hold shift and the up arrow, it moves that note up an entire octave, right? So let's have a listen to this, and then we're going to move on to audio. Amazing. Cool. So that's a little bit of a 101 on MIDI. Just quickly to finish talking about some of the controls, and then we'll go to the audio. You can control the channel being on and off here, right? This one actually just completely turns it off when it's deactivated, so you don't hear anything, right? Turn it back on. Here, this is solos it, so we just listen to that channel if we've got multiple channels playing, right? So that's solo, and you have to be careful with that because sometimes you're going to notice that you've got things soloed and you can't hear anything, and you're like, well, what's going on? Oops, I forgot I soloed something. We'll get to that when we're recording stuff into Ableton in a later video. Here, we've got the volume. And volume in Ableton might work a little bit weird for you if it's the first time dealing with audio systems, audio software, sorry. So negative infinity, Jesus, that's a very infinite way of putting it. So negative infinity means silence, right? There's no volume. So, and then it comes up to +6, right? So zero is typically where we're going to have things. And then if we want it to be quieter, we turn it down. And generally, we should probably turn things down rather than turn things up. Just makes it a bit easier. So that's volume. Cool. If these meters are hitting the red, it might be a good idea to pull things down. Because as a beginner musician, you're going to have trouble figuring out, you know, oh God, all this stuff's too loud and then all this stuff's too quiet and how do I balance it all out? So just slowly try and work on the process of turning everything down. And then the one instrument that you want to be really loud, you know, turn that up above everything else and then, you know, balance things against that. Cool. Panning. Panning is, if you're listening to headphones right now, you've got a direct left and you've got a direct right. So if I grab the pan and I put it all the way to the right and then have a listen to this. It's on the right. And if I go all the way to the left, it's on the left, right? So this changes where the sound sits in the stereo field. So we can go, right, so I'm going from left to right and back again. Trippy. Cool. Yep, you can play around with where you're going to sit sounds in the stereo field. Cool. All right, we've got a couple minutes left before the end of the tutorial, so let's go ahead and play with some audio, and then we're going to call it a day. So, audio, where the hell do you get audio from? So, you could jump on a website such as Splice, and you could get some samples. You could jump into Google and you could go free audio samples and you could go, I want the sound of water dripping or a river flowing or whatever the heck you want. I've got a folder here that has a bunch of underwater samples in it, right? So that's cool. It's probably a bad idea. They're really, really long samples. So it's like, it's kind of boring. Well, what else have we got? I got some really intense shit in here, actually. Do you want to hear some really, really intense stuff? That's pretty cool. Right, so in here, I can actually browse to a folder on my computer where I've got samples. So if you want to make a sample folder where you're going to put everything, and then you go add folder, and then you can navigate, right? So I could put the folder on my desktop. I could go, all right, desktop, new folder, samples, right? Select folder. Boom, now samples is here. I can go inside it. I can grab the audio that I've downloaded from this free website. I click it and then I drag it, and I'll do it over here just so. I click it, I drag it, and I drop it, right? And here's the sample, here's the clip. If I press at the start, press spacebar, we got our crunchy alien sounding dude, right? Now, if I wanna move it around, I need to put my cursor at the top over the title where the hand turns into that, where it turns into a hand, right? Click, drag, drop. Click, drag, drop. Right, let's say I want to make another copy of it. I want two of them. I want one to play there, and then I want another one to play after. I can click on it. I can hold control. I can drag. I can find a place where I want to drop it. I'm still holding control. I let the mouse go. Boom, there's two of them. Right, another way to do that, click, go control C for copy, and then I place my cursor where I want the new one, and then I go control V, paste, bam. Another way, click, control, D, duplicate, right? So that just puts another one, boom, directly next to it. So I could go control D, control D, control D, etc., etc. Okay, I want to go back, control Z, control Z, control Z. I want to go all the way back to here. All right, some other cool little things. We need to zoom in. We need to be closer in. So I can click on the audio sample. I can press Z on my keyboard, boom. I've zoomed right in onto that sample, right? I clicked the title, I pressed Z, I'm all the way in. Now I'm gonna press the minus on my keyboard. Minus goes out. I'm gonna press plus on my keyboard. Plus goes in, right? So plus, minus, Z, boom. I can also put my cursor up the top here where it turns into this magnifying glass. Now this one's a little bit of a tricky one to get your head around. Sometimes it really screws with you. So click it, right? Click and hold. And if you drag down, you go in, right? And if you move from side to side, then you get all wonky. So if you try and just pull directly down, you zoom directly in. If I push directly up, then I zoom directly out, right? So boom, 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 boom. We're going in and out. It gets really confusing. And then if you go sideways, you end up whipping all around. So just be careful that you're going directly up and down. Sometimes the keyboard can be quicker. So click on the thing that you want to zoom in on. Boom, there it is, right in your face. All right, so now I want to teach you something that's just happened, right? So before we were seeing, you know, just whole numbers. Now we're seeing divisions. So what we're seeing is we're seeing one beat, two beat, three beat, four beat. And then we're also seeing divisions of that beat. So if I right click on the grid, I can change the division sizing that I see. So I can go, I want to see 16th notes. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16. Right, so 16 note divisions in that bar. So I can change it to 32. Okay, I've got 32 there. Right, so you can see all that. So what we're going to do now is I'm going to teach you how to do some cool little tricks so you can start screwing around with your audio. Starting now, now that I've got this on, right, I'm snapping to these 32 divisions. So I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to click on this first division. I'm going to go control E. There I've just cut the clip, right? Control E, I cut it again. I clicked across. I'm going to click across again. Control E, control E, control E, control E. I'm slicing it up into little pieces. I'm just going to keep going until I get to there, right? Now I'm gonna go back, and that one, I'm gonna click it, and I can press zero on my keyboard. And what that does is it just sort of mutes it. It's gone, right? If I click it again, I go, it's back, right? So toggling, zero toggles on or off. So I'm gonna turn that one off, I'm gonna turn that one off, gonna turn that one off, gonna turn that one off. And then I'm gonna turn every second one off, right? So I'm gonna do this, and now I come to the beginning. Right. I've just micro-edited that. Cool, so I've just sliced it up really quickly. What I could do as well is I could come in here and I could go, all right, click there, control E, grab it, pull it away, put it there, right? I can do all sorts of stuff. I could also use these little guys here as volume fades, right? So that's fading the volume. You can see it's adjusting how the waveform looks. So I grab that, pull it, volume, right? If I put my cursor over this one, I can see volume fades on that as well. So I can go like, okay, I'm going to fade the volume in and out. I'm going to, okay, yeah, you can see what it's doing to the waveform. Right. Cool, so we're learning how to do a lot of manipulation here. So I'm just grabbing, I'm dragging side to side up the top here just to quickly move myself around. This is usually how I move around in Ableton. I usually click and pull myself around. So yeah, I'm seeing all these divisions. I can select an area and I can go Control E and it slices that entire part and I can get rid of that whole part. Right. And I can do the same with the MIDI clip. So I can actually slice pieces out of the MIDI clip, right? And now if I slice that out, I get to here and that's not playing. It's because I've actually cut off the beginning of the MIDI. So if I cut it there, it's okay. But that bottom note's not gonna play because I've cut it in half, right? So you just have to be careful when you're cutting up MIDI. You don't wanna slice notes in the, you can't just go like this, cut it, get rid of that part and then expect it to play from there because your note doesn't start there. The note started back at the beginning and you've just cut it off. So you're better off actually going in now and drawing a new note and blah, blah, blah. Cool. There's lots of little things like that that you're going to need to learn over time. That's what I'm here for. This was about 26 minutes inside of Ableton Lite. Hopefully that's got a little bit of a start for you. You might be sitting there right now, wide-eyed and stunned. You can slow me down. In the cog down there, you can make me really slow. You can speed me up if you think I don't move quick enough as well. You can also watch me again. So make sure you utilize those. You can watch me as many times until it sinks in. I'm going to be releasing more videos on Ableton Lite specifically. You guys are going to have a lot of content to watch. I hope you really enjoyed this. Again, I was Andrew. Thank you so much for watching. Consider subscribing. There's going to be heaps of great content. Thank you very much.